So you'll notice some of the kids who were playing a woodwind or a brass instrument then scuttled over to the back section where Mr. Hartman is now, and now they are percussionists. Before we play our last program, or last piece with the sixth grade, some of you know it's our tradition to kind of highlight and honor a student from each grade level, from each of the bands. Basically a student who exemplifies all of the qualities that we kind of look for in a model band student. And so this, because of additional fundraising that we were able to do throughout the year, we were actually able to offer another opportunity. Each person who is awarded this accolade also gets admission to the Ohio Wesleyan University Middle School Band, Choir, and Orchestra Summer Camp. It is July 8th through 12th. And essentially, they get to be, they get to play alongside other kids from this area, from the Delta region, Columbus region, Marion, Upper Sandusky, etc. And they also get a private lesson. So in total, this prize is actually worth about $300. And so this year's sixth grade outstanding band member is Hayden Conacher.
Thank you.
seventh grade band. If you need to stand, raise your hand, please. You're good? Go ahead and stand in the flutes, okay. All right, the next group that we have to perform is the seventh grade concert band. And before we play their first piece, if you are a band or orchestra student who participated in the solo and ensemble event last month, essentially, students have to prepare an extra solo or ensemble piece of music outside of the pieces you're hearing today. So if that is somebody, and then what they did was they got critiqued and evaluated by judges that we brought in from other parts of the state. And so they came in on a Saturday, they gave up their Saturday. So if that was you, if you did solo and ensemble, please stand up. Give them a hand. We have three pieces for you today with the seventh grade band. The first is, if there's any type of style that's very important and appropriate for bands, it's marches, because we march down the parade, there's military bands, that's kind of how bands started, was in the military. And so, in seventh grade, we really try and teach this style to them, and through the first piece today, they will perform for you Twin Cities March by John Edmondson.
Thank you.
Before we give it to the orchestra here, the 7th and 8th grade orchestra, we wanted to highlight our 7th grade Outstanding Band Member Award for 2019. This young gentleman is always dependable, always reliable musically, and just a nice kid. Eats lunch with us every day, just hangs out. And one of the many reasons why he's a part of OMEA, and he did solo ensemble. And you'll notice the kids who are given these awards always go above and beyond. And so this year's award goes to Cameron Williams. We have a Starburst, we promise. All right, Mr. Patterson, here you go.
All right, in front of me here, I have the 7th and 8th grade combined orchestra. This group complements each other well. The 8th grade is very, very violin heavy, and the 7th grade is very, very cello heavy, and we combine them in a really well balanced orchestra. So that's what we do. Anyway, to avoid me jumping back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, I'm just going to explain all three pieces now, and we're going to run through all of them in a row. The first piece we've got is called La Festividad, after many of San Obama. Honestly, I was just kind of feeling a little Latin and just picked another one for the 7th and 8th grade. So it's a fun piece, it's a festival feel, a festive feel, got a bounce to it, and it's got a lot of low C sharps, which is a bit of a cello that should have them that by now. After that is a song called Creepy Crawl, which is in the very scary key of B flat, which may be a normal, how you start off key for the band, but for the orchestra, it is about as far away from the beginning of how you learn as you can get. So it's really impressive to see them play in that key. Finally, we have a song where I'm honestly convinced some publishers give their songs wild names so that orchestra directors and standing sheet music right wing through the various pages have to stop and look at it for a second. Which worked, because I was flipping through, I saw a song called Escape from Black Licorice Forest, which admittedly caught my eye. I took a look at it, I liked it, and now we're playing it. Alright, those are our three songs. Thank you.
7th and 8th grade orchestra. Before we get started with our last group for the evening, just a few announcements. One is an opportunity that we're taking advantage of. It's a fundraising opportunity. And basically what it is, at Garfield Park, there is an adult softball baseball league that happens every Friday evening from now until in July, I believe. And we're looking for helpers to help us run the concession stand every Friday evening from about 5:30 p.m. to close to 11:30 after the three games play. So if that's something that is up your alley or you're interested after the concert, please come find me. Looking for help every Friday night from now until the end of July. Second announcement I have is regarding a performance that the 7th and 8th grade group that you're about to hear has this weekend. So make sure you're paying attention, students and families. On Friday, this is slightly unrelated, but on Friday, those students that are in choir and competing at OMIA, they won't be attending on Friday to OMIA. And then on Saturday, the group seated before you that's about to perform, they will perform at OMIA on Saturday morning. So the report time for band students on Saturday is at 6:45 a.m. Same outfit they have on right now, 6:45 a.m. Enter just like they did this evening for the concert. And then the following weekend, we have a trip to Cedar Point that involves the band, choir, and orchestra. That's the 18th. And again, the bus is scheduled to be here at 7 a.m. for that, so we'll have a very early report time and some more information to pass out to kids in the next week after the weekend. So, two busy weekends ahead for middle school music students, but we're really looking forward to seeing how much they grow in those 2 weeks. We'd like to take a second to recognize our OMIA ensemble. Our 8th graders, they perform that ensemble by default, but we hand-select a few 7th graders that come in during their lunchtime to work a little bit. So if you are a 7th grade OMIA participant, please stand now so we can recognize you. 7th grade OMIA participants. So before the 7th and 8th grade band, or the OMIA ensemble, before they perform, we actually have a percussion ensemble. Percussionists, wave your hands. Percussionists, hello. Okay, so those percussionists back there, they've had a busy couple months here of performances. They've performed at our talent show, and they performed at the solo ensemble contest. And today we thought it would be fun to open up the OMIA set with them performing their percussion ensemble piece, Viva Los Besos. So, percussion, go ahead and take it away. Thank you.
Thank you.
We have a very special honoree that we'd like to recognize. And this is our 8th grade outstanding member. And again, this person will get a full scholarship to attend the Ohio Wesleyan University band camp, which is the week of July 8th through the 12th. And this this student typically flies under the radar, always does the right thing, and it's just everything that embodies what we feel is an exemplary band student. And a lot of times we feel like people like this don't get enough recognition for the good that they do, both meeting the band and the school as a whole. So we're very happy to recognize Casey Remington as the 8th grade outstanding.
And we have one last number for everybody. Thank you so much for your patience. Thank you to whichever admin turned on the air conditioning. That was awesome. Yes. And so we just ask that if you could help us out with racking the chairs and the stands and helping us get all of our equipment back, we would greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much, everybody. Our last number tonight is The Forge of Vulcan by Michael Sweeney.